Syscare IT, and I want to explain you how to load the VM instance in Google Cloud Platform. So let's start. So this is my you can say dashboard of Google Cloud Platform, and here we can see the project info, which is named as a ArcSlurf project, and the project number, the ID of the project is mentioned here. And here is the compute engine where you can see all the graph of the system is going on. So recently I have on the system, so this graph is running. So here, and the status of the Google platform is mentioned, whatever services you are using, and the bill which is generated as per the estimated charges will be mentioned here based on the date, and error reporting is also available. API which is using as per the sites, the websites for the mapping and Google Maps, etc. And the trust you can see here, and guest start kit, news, documentations, etc. So let's see how to install, how to load the VM instance. So here is the navigation menu, click on it, and in that you have to go down, go to compute engine. In compute engine you can see the VM instance, just click on it. After clicking, it will show you the settings, the configurations. My internet speed is very low, that's why it is going on process. So once it will, it is loaded. So here, as I have earlier configured the Windows Server 2000 R2, which is right now on, so it is giving me the external IP. Once you will shut down the system, this IP will be released. So you have to understand that once the system will be get on, your external IP will be activated. So let me show you how to create this thing. So you have to create this, click on create instance. After clicking it, here is the name. You can mention the name, whatever name you want. So I am typing Windows. So let me show you what we have to select in region, region and zone. Select the nearest area wherever you stay, so that the system will be loaded very quickly, and you will access it very easily because the area is nearest to you. Here is the machine configuration. You have to select the machine configuration, where is the CPU, the RAM, and here is the different type of CPUs for high memories, for lower memories, and standard. You can select here. Okay, so go down, and here is the boot disk where you have to select whatever operating system you want. So I am selecting the Windows Server. So the system is loading. Okay, once it is displayed, so scroll down. After scroll down, you have to see where is your system. The system is the Windows Server 2012 Data Center R2. So select it. And here is the booting type, whatever type you want. It's a standard, disk, tens, disk. And another one is SSD disk, which is most faster, you can say, more faster than the standard one. So I am selecting the standard one because normally I just want to make the video, that's why. It's a GB where you can see select the hard disk size. And remember one thing, whatever size, whatever system configuration you are selecting here will be charged based on the usage. Okay, so here is the settings. Okay, what to select first? Okay. First of all, I am selecting this thing. and then hit on select. You give me the error message, which will be 50 GB. Okay, now select it. After selecting this firewall setting, you have to allow for HTTP traffic and HTTPS traffic. After that, click on create. So earlier on, just as I've showed you that I've created this thing. So after create, you will see that your system has been loaded, and after loading, you will get this external IP which you have to save in your notepad, whatever. Then you can connect from your the RDP connection. So click on RDP. RDP is getting loaded, and you will be asked for the password. Administrator password will be nothing. You have to just hit on OK. So previously I have given the password for this thing. So the username and the password I will type here. Typing, click on OK, and here finally I have installed the server 2012 R2 data center. So here is, as you can see on the screen, that the dashboard has been loaded. So you can use the system whatever your uses, your for your project, for temporary purpose, and one thing, that this system will be accessed from any system. Just you have to note down this external IP through the RDP connection. You can configure this RDP, so through the internet connection you can access the cloud-based Windows server. So that's it. Let me end this video. So don't forget to subscribe and like this video, comment if you have any question. So that's it. Keep patience. Goodbye.